You don't have to work and slave. Let electricity do it for you. You can have your...
3, 1, 0. Main event of the evening.
Wednesday and half past the hour.
Johnny Jupiter, a human, more or less. Major Domo, chief of the robots, and Reject, the factory rejected robot.
Hi, this is Principal Ortega from Azalea Park Baptist School, and I thank you so much for watching our project on Black History Month. It is so essential that our students understand and that they remember the history of African Americans. We must celebrate not only in February, but the entire year. Our country was born in the midst of chaos. People seeking freedom of religion came to the United States and found Native Americans. So everything started with a big migration. Native Americans became friends. They taught the foreigners how to hunt, and they taught them how to survive in the United States. Later on, became 13 colonies. And with the 13 colonies and the growth of the population, ships were sent specifically to the continent of Africa, to the central and west parts of Africa. And in these ships, through the transatlantic slave trade corporation, many men were captured, men and women, and brought here as slaves. And that is how our history continued, unfortunately. And these men and women that did not ask to be brought here were sold. And it is essential that we understand our history so that it is not repeated. It is essential that we remember that Native Americans were our friends and that they helped us survive here. And it is essential to know as well that African Americans grew here, but were brought by force. It's something that we want our students to respect. And this month we celebrate Black History Month because we know that there are men and women that have made a permanent difference in the United States. And we want our students to remember that and respect their history. This is who we are, and I hope that you continue to tell your child or your children about the values that we hold so dear. And by knowing this history, we are hoping that it's not repeated. There's so much more that needs to change, and we want to make a difference as a school. And that's the reason why we've created this project, and I hope that you enjoy the show. Our students did a great job, and I want to thank every teacher that cooperated, and especially Edil Santana, our music teacher, and Mrs. Morejon. Ms. Morejon helped us in putting together this entire program. So thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy the program.
One of the most memorable Americans ever to confront the issue of racial segregation head-on in this country 40 years ago. Rosa Parks, who in refusing to give up her seat on a city bus to a white man became the mother superior of the civil rights movement. This week, at the age of 82, she's traveling this country with a group of students. Her story and what she is telling them in her own words tonight.
Remember well these struggles that we went through during my childhood when the Ku Klux Klan was very active. It just made us stronger to continue the struggle for freedom. This was the seat that I took as I got on the bus. A few white people boarded the bus, and one man was left standing. And I certainly did not plan to stand up, and I didn't consider myself breaking the law because I was in what was supposed to be our part of the bus. So my arrest brought about a protest from the people of Montgomery that lasted 381 days. And when we did go back on the bus, we didn't. The Supreme Court had handed down a decision that there would be no more racial segregation in transportation. When I was on the bus the time I was arrested, the only thing that was on my mind was that I did not want to be treated in that way.
It took her sitting down to get a people to stand up. And we can never, ever, ever forget her for that.
Once you change your philosophy, you change the thought pattern. Once you change your thought pattern, you change your attitude. Once you change your attitude, it changes your behavior pattern. And then you go on into some action. As long as you got a sit-down philosophy, you have a sit-down thought pattern. And as long as you think, sit-down thought, you will be in some kind of sit-down action. They all have you sitting in everywhere.
Who taught you to hate the color of your skin to such extent that you bleach to get like the white man? Who taught you to hate the shape of your nose and the shape of your lips? Who taught you to hate yourself from the top of your head to the soles of your feet? Who taught you to hate your own kind? Who taught you to hate the race that you belong to? So much so that you don't want to be around each other. No, before you come asking Mr. Muhammad, does he teach hate? You should ask yourself, who taught you to hate being what God gave you?
Begins with a dreamer. Always remember that you have the strength, patience, and the passion to reach for the stars. Over the past few months, we have seen racial injustice at its worst, and it's time for a protest, a peaceful protest. Now I present to you the sixth grade class.
Turn to the sun. Weight on my shoulder, I pull it in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can, what I can, what I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home, far across the river. Can you hear freedom call?
Feel it in my bones.
across the river. Can you hear freedom calling, calling me to answer?
Where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. Let freedom ring, and when this happens, when we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus washed,
Jesus washed,
Jesus washed,
Jesus washed, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus was.
When Jesus was.
When Jesus was.
When Jesus was.
When my Jesus was.
When Jesus was.
He washed my sins away.
La, 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 la,
la, la, la.
Take the oath, Senator?
I am.
I, Barack Hussein Obama,
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear
that I will execute the office of President to the United States faithfully.
That I will execute
the office of President of the United States faithfully. And will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
President Obama was the 44th president. Educations and jobs. Mr. Obama entered college in Los Angeles in 1979. After 2 years, he transferred to Columbia University in New York City, graduating in 1983 with a degree in political science. He graduated Manga Cum Laude from Harvard Law in 1991. After graduating from Columbia University as and undergrad, Obama worked in the business sector for 2 years. He moved to Chicago in 1985, where he worked on the Improving South side as a community organizer for low-income residents.
Michelle and Barack, obstacles. Both of them had to deal with racism during their lives, and especially when they were in the White House. Michelle and Barack both speak out racism and bringing people together. Their saying is,
when they go low, I go high.
Influence in society. Michelle has many charities that help the community. A lot of them are about kids helping with their schooling. A lot of them are also about making women of color feel stronger. Barack changed history by being our first African American president. He let all young men of color know that they can be president too if they try.
Before being the first lady, Michelle Robinson lived in Chicago, Illinois, and was large. She also wanted to Harvard Law School. Michelle Obama was the first African American first lady. She was living full of spunk and style. Michelle's mother moved into the White House to take care of the children, so the country also had a first grandma too.
He also was a writer. He wrote books like Dream from My Father, The Audience of Hope, and many more.
She planted the very first vegetable garden at the White House.
Barack Obama, who was born in Honolulu, Hawaii on August 4, 1961. His mother, who was white, Anya Dunham, was born in Wichita, Kansas in 1942. His father, who was black, Barack Obama Sr., was born in Kenya in 1936. Barack Obama went to school in Indonesia in his early years, until he moved back to Hawaii in his high school years. After graduating from high school, he moved to California when he earned full scholarship in Occidental College in Los Angeles. Then he went in 1983 in Columbia College when he graduated with a major in political science with specialty in international relations. Obama, who is a Protestant Christian, religion view developed in his adult life.
Three.
Michelle Robinson Obama was born in January 17, 1964 in Chicago. She was an attorney graduation from Princeton University and Harvard School of Law. June 1989, Obama met Michelle Robinson when she was an employee as summer associate in Chicago law firm.
Three.
And were married on October 1992. They have two daughters, Mariela and Natasha Obama. He became a U.S. Senator representing Illinois from 2005 to 2008. Barack Obama was the first black person to become the president of U.S. in 2009 and served two terms.
Hi, my name is Yarielis Baez, and for the person I wanted to do for my project is Michelle Obama. So here's some facts about her. Michelle Obama is a lawyer and writer who was the first lady of the United States from 2009 to 2017. Birth dates, January 17, 1964, age 57, place of birth, Chicago, Illinois. She is the wife of the 44th U.S. President, Barack Obama. As a little girl, she played the piano. She had good grades growing up. This is Michelle Obama. This is Michelle Obama. The Robinson family lived in a small bungalow on Chicago South Side. They were a close-knit family. She has become a role of for woman. She has been married for 29 years with Obama. Her and Obama have two kids together. This is Michelle Obama. This is Natasha. And this is Marianne. And this is Barack Obama. My Black History Project. Bye.
Today, I say to you that the challenges we face are real. They are serious and they are many. They will not be met easily or in a short span of time. But know this, America, they will be met. We must pick ourselves up, dust ourselves off, and begin again the work of remaking America. For everywhere we look, there is work to be done.
Now, as the first couple takes their first dance as President and First Lady of the United States, please welcome Beyoncé.
United States Air Force Captain Remishe Nelson, a native of Douglasville, Georgia, has achieved the heights of her profession as a pilot in the Air Force. She recently became the first Black American woman to become a member of the elite Air Force demonstration team, the Thunderbirds. During the Air Force career, she has led PA teams in Turkey, Botswana, and various locations in Europe. Before joining the Thunderbirds, she was the Chief of Public Affairs for the 8th Fighter Wing at Kwansin AB, Republic of Korea. She is in her second season with the team and hails from Douglasville, Georgia.
Dina Benjamin was born October 26, 1956 in Mobile, Alabama, and is currently 64 years old. During high school, she went to Fairhope High School, in which she graduated from. Then for college, Regina attended at Xavier University of Louisiana in New Orleans, where she was initiated into Gamma Alpha. Regina also received her MD degree from the University of Alabama and finished her residency at the Medical Care of Central Georgia. She is known for being a former Vice Admiral in the U.S. Public Health Service Commission Corps, in which she served as the 18th Surgeon General of the United States for 4 years.
Born October 20th, 1964, in Oakland, California, I am a graduate from Howard University and the University of California Hastings College of Law. I am a member of the first historically African-American Greek letter sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha. I serve as the Attorney General of California, as well as the United States Senator from California. As of January 20th, 2021, I am officially the first African-American and Asian-American highest-ranking female. Ladies and gents, I am your Madam Vice President, Kamala Harris. While I may be the first woman in this office, I will not be the last, because every little girl out there seeing this sees that this is a country of possibilities.
I, Kamala Davy Harris, do solemnly swear.
Kamala Davy Harris, I solemnly swear
that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
That I will well and faithfully discharge.
That I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office on which I am about to enter.
The duties of the office upon which I am about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
T minus 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have engine ignition.
Main engine start. And we have liftoff up in Perry for NG-15 mission, the Wallace Flight Facility. Engines are at 100%. Attitude, core pressures, and vehicle subsystems are nominal.
The SS Katherine Johnson takes flight on this, the 59th anniversary.
My name is Katherine Johnson. I was born on August 26, 1918, towards the end of summer in the beautiful state of West Virginia. Oh boy, did I like to count. I would count steps, dishes, almost anything and everything. I became an American mathematician who calculated and analyzed the flight paths of many spacecrafts for more than 3 decades with U.S. space program. I helped send astronauts to the moon. I began working as an African-American woman who may manually perform complex mathematical calculations for the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, or the NACA program engineers. These compilations were essential for the success of the early U.S. program. During those times, NACA segregation, but all changed when NACA was incorporated into the newly formed National Astronauts and Space Administration, NASA. Thank goodness they banned segregation. After that, I was able to focus solely on my job with support of my colleagues, Dorothy Vaughn, who was both a respected mathematician, and Mary Jackson, who was NASA's first African-American manager and mathematician and aerospace engineer.
My name is Nat King Cole, and welcome to the Nat King Cole Show. And for a lot of you that don't know me, I was the first Black American to have a TV show in the U.S. My show ran a little over a year, but it helped African Americans take a big step forward in the TV industry. And I am primarily known for being a music entertainer, I sing, and I play the piano. And I was born in March 17th in the year of 1919 in Montgomery, Alabama. Even though my family and I lived in Hollywood, we still faced racism every single day. But I do my best to keep a smile on my face, and let me tell you, it was pretty hard to do. And I am happy that I have had a chance to help the future of the Black Americans, but I plead with everyone that we stop treating each other badly. Ladies and gents, please help me bring out another pioneer that helped the Black Americans take a big step forward in the TV industry, Ella Fitzgerald.
I'm an American jazz singer, known across the states, first lady of soul, queen of jazz. But you should call me Lady Ella. My struggle was real as a Black woman raising my son, Ray Brown Jr. I was born on April 25th, 1970. We've encountered people that did not like us just because of the color of my skin. No matter if my voice sounded beautiful, hidden high notes no one else can, but I did not let that stop.
Wonderful. Well, Ella, would you like to sing us a little something so we can all hear your voice?
Yes.
Everybody, another round of applause for Ella Fitzgerald.
Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do I, 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 do I. It don't mean a thing, all you gotta do is sing. Do I, 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 do I. Makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you've got. Oh, don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. Do I, 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 do I. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do I, do I.
Stop to see pretty cherry blossoms. No more we neath the tree looking at the sky. Sayonara, sayonara, goodbye.
I can fly, I can fly, I can fly. 20th century, African Americans were not allowed to join all white organizations known as fraternities and sororities on college campuses. To have a place where they call their own, several African Americans developed 9 individual fraternities and sororities that represent their passion, education, and similar mindsets. Starting from universities that were created for the same reason, known as historically black colleges, or HBCUs, like Howard University, to predominantly white institutions, or PWIs, like Indiana University, African Americans such as Henry Arthur Callis, Ethel Hedgman Lane, Myra Hemings, Elder Watson Diggs, Frank Coleman, Arizona Clever, Mary Lou Allison Gardner Little, and A. Langston Taylor, and their co-founders developed 5 fraternities and 4 sororities that were named the Divine Nine. Traditions of song and dance kept on to promote their pride following Christian beliefs. These 9 organizations developed stepping as a way to mix their new and old cultures in a whole new light. So without further ado, I would like to present to you APBS 10th grade class following the Divine Nine.
Incorporated, the first black fraternity in history, 1906.
Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, founded in 1908.
Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, 1911.
Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, founded in 1913.
Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, founded in 1911.
Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, founded in 1920.
Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated, founded in 1914.
And Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated, founded in 1922.
By the shrine, the storm's like my frat, and it ain't gonna be no stuff like that. You know why?
Why?
'Cause they can't stomp like us.
like yesterday, we used to rock the show. I laced the track, you locked the flow. So far from hanging on the block for dough. Notorious, they got to know that life ain't always what it seemed to be. Words can't express what you mean to me. Even though you're gone, we still a team.
How come you don't want me, man?
In the future, can't wait to see if you open up the gates for me. Reminisce sometime.
I just don't want to go back to being just a relative again. I love you, Uncle Phil, and I just don't want to lose you, you know, any of you.
You're not going to lose us. You are my son, Will. End of story. You just better be sure that your butt is by a phone on Sunday.
I was with you, Matlock.
That's very funny, Hetty Murphy.
You just happen to have a blowtorch with you.
I need this for work, man.
God knows, y'all.
Watching us while we pray for you. Every day we
some American. You try to protect your family the best you can, but in the end, there's not really much you can do. Because, see, gas pipes burst. People rob houses. Planes fly into buildings. So what you going to do? You going to live in fear? You got to live your life. Have fun. Be yourself. Make mistakes. See, Bernie Mac may have overreacted. One thing he did get right, it's important to be together. So I told you once before, America, we're family. You and I, we are family. Always and forever. Y'all take care.
But we will march with the spirit of love and with the spirit of dignity that we have shown here today. We must say, wake up, America, wake up, for we cannot stop and we will not and cannot be patient.
Sometimes you need to feel the pain and sting of defeat to activate the real passion and purpose that God predestined inside of you. God says in Jeremiah, I know the plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Graduating class, hear me well on this day. When you have reached the hilltop and you are deciding on next jobs, next steps, careers, further education, you would rather find purpose than a job or a career. Purpose crosses disciplines. Purpose is an essential element of you. It is the reason you are on the planet at this particular time in history. Your very existence is wrapped up in the things you are here to fulfill. Whatever you choose for a career path, remember the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. When I dare to challenge the system that would relegate us to victims and stereotypes with no clear historical backgrounds, no hopes or talents, when I question that method of portrayal, a different path opened up for me. The path to my destiny. When God has something for you, it doesn't matter who stands against it. God will move someone that's holding you back away from a door and put someone there who will open it for you. If it's meant for you, I don't know what your future is, but if you are willing to take the harder way, the more complicated one, the one with more failures at first than successes, the one that has ultimately proven to have more meaning, more victory, more glory, then you will not regret it. Now, this is your time. The light of new realization shines on you today. Howard's legacy is not wrapped up in the money that you will make, but the challenges that you choose to confront. As you commit to your past, press on with pride and press on with purpose. God bless you. I love you, Howard. Howard forever.